Hey guys, Tabinator5000 here with another review for you today. This time, it's the Nintendo 64. Very nice system in my opinion. It first started production in 1994. It was originally called Project Reality, and then it was delayed pretty much a bajillion times. The name was changed to Nintendo Ultra 64, and eventually was released in 1996. As just the Nintendo 64. But that's enough history. Let's look at the actual system. On the front you have your Nintendo 64 logo, your four controller ports, which is quite nice. On the top you have on and off switch, reset button, cartridge slot, and expansion port, which you use to put the expansion pack inside, which increases the RAM inside. But originally, before the expansion pack came out, it used this thing, the jumper pack. Pretty much just a small replacement for the expansion pack. Didn't really change anything. On the back, you have places for your AC adapter and AV. The AV, not much to say about it. It's only a special thing if the exact thing connection is the Super Nintendo one, and the AC adapter. It actually has an external power supply, which means you connect this big hook to your system, and then it actually just ends with a regular small plug. Very nice, I must say. It is quite helpful when it comes to organizing. But that's enough about the actual system. What about the controller? Well, odds are you had a controller like this. This is the one that originally came with it. It was gray, though there were many other colors later, like this black one and many transparent ones, like blazing orange or force green. But the actual controller is very interesting. Three handles, first off. Here you got your D-pad, your AB button, and your C buttons, which are like a second D-pad, like Virtual Boy. You got L and R buttons, start button, and an analog stick, which is actually one of the first ones analog sticks that were made analog sticks popular. But on the bottom here, you also have your Z button right here. So this whole middle section is sort of like the nunchuck for the Wii, which is quite interesting. On the back you may also a second extension port. This was used for memory card, which was not, I don't have, but it's not mandatory for many games, or the Nintendo Rumble Pack. First Rumble Pack ever, I believe. So what you do, you just place it like this, make sure it's connected where this part kind of fits in and finishes the finish, and voila, you have a Rumble Pack. It does add weight, but I actually kind of like the added weight, and it has a little motor inside, so in the game, there are many games supporting it, and in those games it will rumble. The motor would run and the control would rumble, which is nice. Like if you crash your car and then boom, and starts rumbling. It's very nice. Very nice addition. But enough about controllers. What about games? Nintendo 64 had what you may call a small game library, but many great games were made. I have seven here. I got Mortal Kombat Trilogy. Pretty fun game. Doesn't work well with the controller. Not a very good controller for fighting games. World Cup 98, sports game, I don't really care. It also needs a memory card. I will get one eventually. Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. Very fun game, but I did not play it much. It's golden, which is cool. It has a weird translucent picture, which is pretty cool. But the reason I did not play the game very much, because I was too busy with Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. Great. Pretty great game. It's amazing. It's really amazing. Deserves all the hype it gets. What else we got? We got Doom 64, the sequel to the original Doom. Pretty fun game. It's sometimes on my TV it's a little hard to see. You can barely see the enemies in the and the walls, but it works. It's kind of fun. It's fun shooting in the enemies with the N64 controller, like a gun. You feel like you're shooting stuff. With the Rumble Pack, which sadly is not used in Doom 64, but like in GoldenEye it's used, and it's pretty cool. We got Star Wars Shadow of the Empire. Fun game, especially for a licensed one. And we got San Francisco Rush. A pretty fun racing game made by Midway. Uses the Rumble Pack very well. Like, you turn and it's like a steering wheel and starts rumbling. And it's pretty fun. It's actually quite fun. But enough about... Let's take a look at some extras I have. First thing first, I got manuals for all the games besides Mortal Kombat and Majora's Mask. We got Doom 64 manual. By the way, manuals back then were much more colorful and vibrant than the ones we get now. San Francisco Rush. Fun game, okay manual. It's kind of fun. Star Wars Shadow of the Empire manual. Actually, really cool manual. Lots of great art, like Boba Fett right here. Looks very nice. World Cup 98 manual, pretty crappy. I mean, no picture. It's just, it looks like the manuals that you get for the actual systems. And finally, Ocarina of Time manual. Excellent, amazing manual for an amazing game. Look at the art. The art is just beautiful. You probably can't see it well because of my crappy camera, but it really looks amazing. The guy that sold me it also threw in this Mario 64 manual. Pretty cool, nice manual, no game, which is sad. Also the two manuals for the actual system, the consumer information and how to connect it to the electricity right here. This is kind of cute. It's an ad for Nintendo Power. You sign up here and you'll get Nintendo Power and a free Mario 64 player's guide. Pretty cool. Also, one more thing I got is a RoboCraft 64 poster. Nice poster, really. And just one more small thing I got. Very minor. I can't believe I'm even mentioning it, but an RF connector. Connect an overly complicated and crappy video quality. What else can you want? Connect this into the N64, TV, all that fun stuff. That's pretty much it. Hope you enjoyed the video. That's Abernathy Fatalan, signing off.